is generally called as Portuguese man of war. So why it is called as Portuguese man of a war? Because this Polipsia, so here the boat, the Portuguese boat, so during the war, so it has been suddenly appeared and it has been disappeared. Likewise, even the Polipsia, it suddenly appeared and gets disappeared. So why? Because this Polipsia, it is having a balloon-like structure called as a pneumatophore. Okay, the balloon-like structure called as pneumatophore. So this structure, when the air occupies on it, then it will come to the surface of a water. Okay, so when the air gets removed from it, so it will get dwells. It will go deep in the water. Okay, so and it is having a tentacles. Okay, it is having a tentacles, and to this and nearby there is a zooids. Okay, there are zooids. So these are zooids, and these are tentacles which have the stringing cells. Okay, so tentacles has the stringing cells. Okay, so this stringing cells, it produces a poison. Okay, it produces a poison which is almost equal to the poison secreted by the cobra. Okay, poison secreted by the cobra. So here this Polipsia, it is having a balloon-like structure called as a pneumatophore. So when the air gets occupied in it, then it will come to the surface. If not, then it will dwell in the water. Then there are certain zooids. Okay, the bunch which is found in a colony, zooid-like structure, and the tentacles which helps in the movement. Okay, so these are the stringing cells. So this stringing cells, it produces a poison. Okay, it produces a poison called as a neurotoxin. Okay, neurotoxin. So this neurotoxin, it damages the nervous system. Okay, so polyps, it is of both the Polipsia is both of polyp and medusa type. Okay, it is both of polyps and medusa type. Okay, so this was one example. Let's see the second example, that is sea anemone. Okay, so second example. So this is third example. In our previous class, we have discussed first two examples. Okay, so the next example, it is sea anemone. Okay, so this sea anemone, so the sea anemone, it is called as a it lives in association with the hermite crab. Okay, with the hermite crab. So this sea anemone, which has association, which has mutual beneficial with the hermite crab. Okay, so that mutual association, it is called as a proto cooperation. Okay, so proto cooperation of the sea anemone with the hermite crab. Okay, so here both the organisms. So which are the organisms here? That is sea anemone and the hermite crab. Okay, so both the organisms are benefited. So means here the sea anemone and hermite crab, they are mutually benefited to each other, but they are not symbiotically associated. Symbiotically associated. Okay, it is not symbiotically associated. So how does sea anemone, it has been associated? benefited with the hermite crab is that, so this hermite crab, okay, so hermite crab, it will lives inside the shell, okay, it will lives inside the shell left by the mollusk. So mollusk nalli ondu shell gal en irutte, so aa ondu empty shell olgade ee hermite crab adu olgade irutte. Okay, hermite crabs, it is present in the shell of a mollusk, okay, the leftover shell of a mollusk. Okay, so this sea anemone, okay, the so hermite crab, it lives in shell, okay, it lives inside the inside the shell. Okay, so this sea anemone, it gets it will be present above that shell. Okay, so sea anemone are present above the hermite crab. Okay, above the hermite crab. So this hermite crab, it is present inside the shell. Okay, so this sea animal's tentacles, it will covers this hermite crab. Okay, so the tentacles covers the hermit crab. So itara tentacles hermit crab na cover aadaga, so the hermit crab, it gets a sort of a protection from the predators. Okay, so here we can find that it is being mutually associated to each other. Okay, mutually benefited to each other, but they are not symbiotically associated. Okay, so that one it is called as a proto-cooperation. So this proto-cooperation is one of the specialized character of a sea animal. Okay, it is one of the specialized character of a sea animal. So the another special character of this sealant ray is that, so it has an exoskeleton. Okay, we can see that, so it has exoskeleton made of calcium carbonate. Okay, so this the special character of the sealant ray is that, so it has a exoskeleton which is made up of calcium carbonate. Okay, so this exoskeleton which is made up of calcium carbonate, so is called corals. Okay, what we call it as corals. In the corals there are two type, one is barrier corals and another one is atoll. Okay, one is barrier coral and another one is atoll. Okay, so this barrier coral, so it get deposited. Okay, so when this sealant when it dies, so that corals, okay, so this corals, it get deposited parallel to the sea shore. Okay, so even the corals enagutte, even the corals on the sea shore nalli deposit aagta barutte. So itara parallel aagi sea shore ke parallel aagi deposit aadaga adakke naavu barrier corals anta helthivi. Okay, so corals gets deposited parallel to the seashore. Gets deposited parallel to the seashore. So because of this deposition, so there is a great barrier coral in the Australia. Okay, so this is important. So the great barrier coral, okay, great barrier coral in the Australia is about 1920 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ ಲಾಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಈ ತರ ಕೋರಲ್ ಡೆಪಾಸಿಷನ್ ಆಗಿ ಆಗಿ ಆಸ್ಟ್ರೇಲಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಒಂದು ಬ್ಯಾರಿಯರ್ ಕೋರಲ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಲಾಂಗ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ 1920 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ ಲಾಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾರಿಯರ್ ಕೋರಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೇ ಪ್ಯಾರಲ್ ಟು ದ ಸೀಶೋರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ದ ಗ್ರೇಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾರಿಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾರಿಯರ್ ಕೋರಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ದ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾರಿಯರ್ ಕೋರಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಆಸ್ಟ್ರೇಲಿಯಾ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಟಾಲ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಟಾಲ್? ಸೊ ಅಟಾಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅ ಡೆಪಾಸಿಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಅಟಾಲ್ ಈವನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅ ಡೆಪಾಸಿಷನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಕೋರಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಕೋರಲ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಕೋರಲ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಅ ಐಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಕೋರಲ್ಸ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಐಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಲ್ ಟು ದ ಸೀಶೋರ್, ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಅಟಾಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕೋರಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಅಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಶಿಯಂ ಕಾರ್ಬೊನೇಟ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಅ ಐಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಲಕ್ಷದ್ವೀಪ್ ಐಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಲಕ್ಷದ್ವೀಪ್ ಐಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೀಲೆಂಟ್ ರೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೊ ವಿತ್ ದಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಸೊ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫೈಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನೋಟಿಸ್ಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಸೀಲೆಂಟ್ ರೇಟ್ಸ್. ನೌ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಸೀ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ that is Ctenophora. So it is third one. The next class it is third one. It is Ctenophora. Okay, the next class let's discuss here about the Ctenophora. Now let's see the general characteristics of this Ctenophora. So this Ctenophora, it is of both lateral and bilateral. Okay, the body symmetry is both lateral and bilateral. Okay, so here the body symmetry is both lateral and bilateral. Okay, so it is having both lateral and bilateral, so hence it is called as a biradial. Okay, so the main and the tangent, so it is radial and bilateral, we call it as biradial. So why we call it as biradial? Because it is of both radial and bilateral symmetry is being present. Okay, and next it is, so here the sex organs are present in the same organism. Okay, so sex organs are present in same organism. Okay, it is being present in the same organism, so hence we know that we call it as hermaphrodite. Okay, inanta kirithivi now idike we call it as hermaphrodite means both the sex organ is present in the single individual. Okay, so here the reproduction takes place by sexual method. Okay, so reproduction, it takes place by the sexual method. And generally this Ctenophora, it is being called as a comb jelly. Okay, so now idana general aagi inanta karithivi we call it as comb jelly. Okay, so some of the characters mentioned here. So it is of the body symmetry is having radial and bilateral. So it has been called as a biradial. Okay, the sex organs are present in the same organism. So hence it is hermaphrodite, and the reproduction it takes place by the sexual method, and generally we call it as comb jelly, because the tentacles, what it is present, the tentacles present here. So it is arranged in a row such that it looks like a comb. Okay, it looks like a comb, and it is a jelly-like material. So we generally call it as comb jelly. Okay, so let's mention here. So we generally call it as comb jelly. Okay, so still character with an example, let's study in the next class. So in this class, we studied about the cylindrates with an example and its characteristics. We studied about polypsia. Okay, so then we know about the sea anemone. Then we discussed about the corals. So in the corals, there are two types. One is barrier corals and another one is atoll. So for the barrier corals, where this coral is being present parallel to the seashore, whereas atoll, it is a circular coral. Okay, for this example, it has been found in the Lakshadweep Island. And for the barrier coral, so the major thing is that, so the Great Barrier Coral we can see in the Australia. So it is around 1920 kilometer long. And then some of the character we have discussed in the next class, Dinophora, some characters. So we shall continue this in our next class. Thank you.